Hey everyone, April Cox here. We are here today with Phyllis Williams, and we are walking through Ingram Spark setup for the first time. And we're going to go ahead and get started. All right. So Phyllis, we have ingramspark.com. We're going to go in and we're going to create or sign up here. It's I want to publish a book, get started. So we're going to click there. And it says here, do you want print and ebook, print book only? So we're only doing print books. So we're just going to hit this one here. And it wants us to then create an account. So contact name, Phyllis Williams. And your email address, and I'll blur this stuff out. So don't worry about that. Can you repeat what your email is? Okay, would you like to receive emails? I'll say no. I'm not a robot. Although some people have accused me of being one. Sometimes I feel like a robot.
I can't imagine.
So I'm going to save this password for you so I can come in and help you from time to time. So now it tells you, thank you, Phyllis, for creating an Ingram Spark account. Just go on the email that was just sent to that email address, and you're going to go and activate your account by clicking on that link.
Okay. I just came out of my email. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Okay, here it is, the link.
So you'll just click on the link there. It just activates the account.
Okay. Okay.
And so now, if you're not looking at my screen, you can go ahead and shut down what you're doing. Do you see how it has policy agreements here on my screen?
Yes. Yes.
So this is, you know, by clicking agree, you understand the terms of use and privacy policy. For the sake of time, I'm not going to go into any of these, and we'll just click agree. Do I have your permission to do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so now we're going to put your name. I won't put your email or mailing address here. Okay, so what's the business account name?
It's R&P Enterprises, INC.
And your location, you are in Kentucky, right? So I'm just going to put Kentucky. Okay. So everything here look okay?
502 Evergreen Way. Yes. Yes.
Okay. And I'm going to hit continue. Okay. So as you see across the top here, and I can zoom in on this a little bit, we're going to go through, we just put in the business info. Now we're going to do some security stuff. So they kind of show you through each step of the way as to what you're going to be going through. So now we're doing security questions. Okay. And they have a few different things to choose from. And then you can put the information here just in case you lose your password. So street you lived on in third grade, and I will edit this out so that we don't provide that information for others. But do you want to choose one of these? So now it's going to move to agreements. But there's no harm just accepting their policies so that you don't have issues later trying to figure out how to get back to this.
Okay.
So I typically, if you want to go into detail and look at the agreements, you can certainly use that. And then we just go to the end and I'll put your name, Phyllis Williams, and owner.
Owner is fine.
So I have your permission to sign the agreements. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. So as we go through the different steps, you're going to see them here. They'll check them off as we go through each one. One of the weird things that happens with Ingram Spark, I'm just going to close this in a little bit, is that when you start clicking on things and doing them, it's very hard to get back to this page. So I'm going to recommend people, when you go in and you're ready to do the next thing, just right click on it and open it in a new tab. So you can always get back here because okay. of the really weird things that happen sometimes with Ingram Spark. It just works better.
Okay. So I'm
going into the other tab. And now it wants to put publisher compensation here. So I'm going to click US dollar and I'm going to click add compensation information. And this is where we put the information about your bank account and how okay. you want the bank stuff to be served up. Now I'm going to pause the recording here. We're okay. going to put this in and then I'll restart the recording. That way we don't have okay. to worry about going back and editing anything. So okay. I'm pausing here. Okay, so we've entered the information here and we have the ability. I just want to point out a couple things. There okay. is a chat feature over here for people who need help. They had turned it off for a while. So it looks like they've put it back in during certain hours of the day. So if okay. you get stuck, you can access the chat feature.
Okay.
Okay, so that's the one that we finished here. That's now what I'm going to do is just go back here, refresh this page, and now it should show that we've completed that section as well. And then the publisher payment, this next piece of it is where, so see now, it took a little while. And by the way, this is actually good that we have it on the screen like this. Sometimes the Ingram Spark website is really slow to respond. Don't worry about it. It's easy to get sidetracked and think I did something wrong. It's just the way it is sometimes.
Okay, so, just be patient.
Yep. And sometimes you have to log out and go back in and hopefully they let you pick up where you left off, but it can be a bit kludgy. They have told us that they are making updates to their website and hopefully things will get better with that. So, okay. So here, next one is add publisher payment. So I'm just going to right click on this again and open it in a new tab. Otherwise, I'll lose that page. So what they want you to do here is just add a new card number. And this will be used when you order books or if you have to pay for an update or something like that, then they will ask you to use one of the cards you have on file. So okay. I'm going to go ahead and pause this recording while we enter card information and then we'll be right back. Okay, so we have entered the card information and now I'm just going to go back here to that previous page and we've done the publisher payment. We're going to go and enter tax information now. Now, if you have a business like Phyllis does, then she can provide me with her EIN number. Or if you are a sole proprietor, you will use your social security number. So if you are a limited liability company, you are typically using, and it's a single member LLC, then you'll just use your social as well. They don't need you to put an EIN number in. So those are some of the things. So here's the information we're going to collect. It's the federal taxpayer ID. Now, like I said, that could be your EIN number, whatever tax identifying number, social security, employer, individual tax number for aliens, and then the state, and then you do the signature. So I'm going to pause this recording again while we fill out this information, and then we'll go to the next step. Okay, so now that we've filled out the information, it pops up with this W-9 form. I'm not going to scroll through it because I don't want to be sharing information that's personal, but you'll be able to scroll through, verify everything is correct, and then you'll be able to move forward.
All righty.
So now that I've submitted that information, it takes us back to this summary page. If you are looking to claim a tax exemption or things like that, there's additional steps that you can take here. And there's a little help information here, or you can get support if you need to dig deeper into that part of it. So now back to the previous page. I just want to refresh everything that we've done, give it a second to update, and then we can do finish setting up my account.
Okay.
Okay, so see, we've got everything checked off. I'm going to do finish setting up my account.
April, thank you.
You're welcome. So it says 100% setup. Now, the funny thing is that many times you're going to get this far. And then when you go back to the dashboard, I hope it doesn't do it this time, but it, when you click go back to dashboard, it tells you that you need to finish setting up your account, which as you can see, we're already set up. So there's this like thing that goes back and forth, and then we have to clear cookies and do things that help, that will cause some confusion and some frustration. But it looks like they're going to let us move forward. So now we're here. Yay. So we'll set up a title. I'm going to go here for print book only because we're not doing an ebook. We're just doing the print books. We're going to do the paperback and the hardcover. So we're going to click this. And then, I'm just going to say, yes, my files are ready. And check off the files listing here. And then you can have the choice between, do you want to print, distribute, and sell the book? Or are you only doing it for your own purposes so that you can print your own books, that you don't want to sell them? So we want to set it up so that we'll be able to sell the books. You'll be able to sell them on behalf of your husband. Oh, here it did it again. Finish account setup. Since you have not completed your account setup, you'll not be able to upload files. Only add metadata. Please take a moment to finish setting up your account. It's a pain in the rear end. It happens a lot with Ingram Spark. I'm going to just pause for a moment. Okay, let's head on over to video number 2 for resolution on this issue and to set up your title. And if you're getting value out of this video, why don't you click the subscribe and the bell button so that you can be alerted when I post new videos. I'll see you on the next one.